So right about now, we would have a feel of the medal. The RBO medal should be ready. The GBA president and his team, together with Mr. Isaac Tete of the TT Brothers, the man who has been refreshing us all day, all night, the man is here. They will join us in the ring with the GBA president, whether Mr. Fadi Fatah, whether Mr. Enes Adi, or the chairman of promotion, Aladi Tofik, and the management of the boxer, the Ghanaian boxer. They should also join us in the ring as we prepare for the main event of the evening. So we are looking forward. Can we also have our father, who is the founder of Akotoku Academy, to join us in the ring? You'll have to join us in the ring for this main event of the evening. Shall we have you in the ring? And Mr. Labi is also a member of the Ambition Boxing Promotion Syndicate. Can you join us in the ring? Join us and let's have fun. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. And let me also invite our treasurer, Mr. Lord Akwey, John Manfo. If our first vice president can make the way, can we have Mr. Rabon Dodo join us here? Nikojo, if Nikojo is closer, Nikojo kindly join us. It's one of our proud chiefs who is here to support us, and we thank you so much for coming. Thank you so much. Kindly guide our friend's vice president, Rabon Dodo, a former boxer and currently the first vice president of Ghana Boxing Authority. Thank you very much, gentlemen, for coming. We appreciate you. Thank you, and thank you very much. Madam, go around with the title and let him have a feel of the title as we wait for the two boxes. Now, officials for this bout. Judge 1, Erasmus O. Judge 2, Clement Ashun. And Judge 3, Shadrach Akwey. The man in charge of this fight is Me Mensah Akakbo. So, can we have Me Mensah Akakbo as we welcome the boxers, Komlagan, Anani, Mateo, and then Michael Ansah. So, shall we please welcome the boxer from Lome, Togo, Komlagan Houkptin.
Give a fuck, boy, Papillon Blue, Sister Bella, Medical Kuvala, Bokaba Michova, Yoko Saninzana, the She Lady, Yoko Noko, Abami Fufui, Fesen Yofufui, Mambo Bachin Tui, something they do me, getting it.
Well, very well, as we wait for the boxes, we would want to take a very short commercial break. While we return, the boxers will be in the ring and we'll roll for the very final bout of the day. Today is Sunday. We start on Saturday. This is the Deluxe Professional Boxing League, week number 10. We'll be right back.
I'm a true champion.
So, shall we please welcome the Ghanaian boxer, Michael Ansah.
Oh, yeah. I saw you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. That was the rival of the boxer from Ghana, Michael Ansah. Now, listen, gentlemen, before the official introduction of the boxers, shall we all stand on our feet to observe the national anthem of Togo and Ghana? So, if we are ready, let's get ready for the national anthem of Togo.
Salut à toi, pays de nos aïeux, toi qui les rends des fonds, paisibles et joyeux, cultivant vertu, vaillance pour la prospérité. Que viennent de les tirer ton cœur, soupir de la liberté. Togo debout, luttons sans défaillance, vaincrons ou mourrons, mais dans la dignité. Rends-toi, nous a exalté, du Togo pour la prospérité. Togo le vient à
Now, the national anthem of Republic of Ghana. To invite the DBA president to give us a brief comment on the world title we are all anticipating.
Yes, we'd like to thank you all for coming, but I know we are keeping the world title. One bullet answer who always make us proud tonight, or let me say this morning, is going to make us proud once again. Thank you.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. Thank you for coming. And now we are ready to introduce the two boxers. So, gentlemen, everybody can take his or her seats for coming. Once again, thank you very much. Now, viewers, wherever you are, you're live on Max Television. This is the ultimate bout of the evening. And this is a world title, Lion Boxing Organization, LBO. Lightweight championship over 12 rounds. We are ready to roll. Now, officials for this bout: Judge 1, Erasmus Oro; Judge 2, Clement Ashon; and Judge 3, Shadrach Akwe. Now, introducing the boxer fighting out from the blue corner, from the Republic of Togo, a boxer spotted this evening with white and red trunks with yellow gloves to match. This is the man with the weight of 135 pounds, and this is the man with the official record of 4 fights, no defeats, 1 draw, 3 wins. 2 of the wins came by way of knockout. He made his debut as a professional boxer in 2015. So far, he has done 14 rounds of boxing. From Lomé, Togo, presenting to you the boxer, Komlagan. Switching over to the red corner. And this evening, spotted in the black and red trunks, black shoes, yellow and red gloves to match. This is the boxer who made his debut in 2010. So far, he has done 208 rounds of boxing with the weight of 134 pounds. This is the man who has set the tone, who has set the tone. As we speak now, he is the number one contender for the Commonwealth title. This is the man with the official record of 34 fights, 22 wins, 10 defeats, 2 draws, 16 of the wins came by way of knockout. Is also known to be called One Bullet. Presenting to you the boxer, Michael Ansah. And the man in charge of this fight is me, Mason Akapo.
Clean and nice fight from you. You must defend yourself at all times and make sure my slotting are straight through me. That's gloves. Good luck.
Round one.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me your ears for this announcement. Car number GC863020. Hyundai Electrol, you have blocked someone who wants to leave the arena. Car number GC863020. Hyundai Electrol, please, wherever you are, move over to your car and repark it. Thank you very much.
Komlagan shot to the head. Michael Ansah misses. Away from the two boxers, really. It's interesting the kind of relationships that have developed since the commencement of the Luxury Professional Boxing League. We've had boxers from Benin grace the occasion. Now we've got the Togolese here as well. And I won't be too surprised that before the end of the season, the Ivorians, the Nigerians, the Nigerians,
End of the first round.
Well, I think if you don't take your part, it's a real good boxer. I mean, he's fought all the finest boxers in Ghana. You know, you can call any name. He's fought that baby. He's loved them fights, but I can tell you that he's one of the best. I mean, he's very crafty. He's a boxer who, his trainer will tell you that with 80% work, you know, at 80% level, he can give you whatever you like. He can go a 12th round without any stress. His fight that he can get that today, I think that he's too aggressive. He's not giving me that attitude. He wanted to finish the fight too early. I think that he must be himself and give us what we are known. We've always known him for. And I believe that he will win when the time comes.
Sure, he'll be more than eager to show what he's made, to show Ghanaians what he's made of. I'm just loving everything about him, particularly his outfit. And I'm not too sure, maybe when he gets into the rough with his opponent, he walks away as if he's wearing, I'm not too sure what to call it, an apron, trying to look a bit flamboyant. Anyway, he will continue from where he left off. Again, trying to use that swing to suppress his opponent. Lands a good one. And then the right comes. Komlagan is shaken visibly. He says, Prince, I'm going home with a title. You know, he's trended for various reasons, but recently, for a tough fight he had, and in the post interview he was asked where he goes from there, and he answered aptly, from here I'm going home. That's a good one to the head, and then Komlan would want to put him in the corner. He walks away, tries to land with the right, but misses, and then connects with the left. Wild miss. The corner, and look at the way Michael Ansah watches his opponent, and then he goes in, one to the body, one to the head. Comes in, but then walks into a straight right from Michael Ansah. And then one to the head from Michael Ansah, and then a wild swing and a miss.
Well, Prince, that is a good round from these two fighters. First round, you can see that both fighters were sizing each other out very, very well. But I feel Michael Ansah did enough for me in round one and to round two. But when you look at Komlagan, you can see that he has the height advantage, the reach advantage too is on his side. So I'm expecting him to use that on his advantage. Make sure he used the jab to blind his opponent when Michael Ansah is coming in. But you know, Michael Ansah's hooks and override
is very, very powerful. And you could see anytime he landed that override and hooks on his opponent, Komlagan, Komlagan just stands and goes back. And that is something Komlagan is trying as much as possible to prevent in the fight so far. But this is a word of advice to Michael Ansah. In as much as he is being confident in the fight so far, he shouldn't be overconfident, because Komlagan has the height advantage and the reach advantage. And you know, when fighters have that long reach, they can give you a counter punch that you don't see coming. And Michael Ansah is really throwing wild. So I'm giving him a head of advice that in as much as he's been growing confidence in the fight so far, his punches, he needs to calculate it very, very well, because a counter punch from Komlagan can see something else from Michael Ansah.
Yeah, probably right. A counter punch would not go the way it should go. Tries to close in on Komlagan, and almost always keeping that right in waiting. Komlagan trying to work on the body now of Bullet. Bullet recounters, takes one to the head of Bullet. He goes into a clinch, Komlagan. Quick misstep, and then he's asking his opponent to cool down, and there he goes again. Is he tired already? Komlagan looks tired. Good shot to the head.
You know, Prince, at this point in time, I feel Michael Ansah should be able to figure his opponent out, because you could see that Komlagan is really tired, he's wearing out, his punches are not really, really powerful as compared to round one. Now his punches are really, really slower as compared to round one, and I'm expecting Michael Ansah to sense that danger and finish up his opponent in front of him.
Prince, this is what I know Bullet and something, you know, this is what he does best. Go in, be calculated, be calm, and work. I don't know why today he decided to throw a lot of wayward punches, which is not helping. He should fight his normal fight. The Togolese is already getting tired. We are just in round three. But like always, Bullet will not give you the chance to think, to put your thoughts together. He will just force you to play to his tactic. And you know, the earlier the Togolese get serious, the better, because it will go down if it plays with Bullet Ansah. One Bullet Ansah is a dangerous chap when it comes to the art of boxing. Very, very dangerous.
And you know, Prince, to add to what my brother Derek said, it has to do with the way the Togolese is seeing how the fight is going. You can see him walking into his corner. He feels growing into confidence, because he feels he's testing the power punches of Michael Ansah, and it is not really, really having an effect on him. We all thought Michael Ansah's power punches should be of a damage to the Togolese, that in the name of Komlagan, but Komlagan so far, he feels testing the power punches of Michael Ansah is not really, really having an effect of him. But you see, the Togolese is really tired, because you can't stand toe to toe with Michael Ansah. Michael Ansah is very strong, and you know, the kind of punches he's unleashing on the Togolese is making the Togolese wear out. So let's see, the Togolese is, still standing in front of Michael Ansah, but Michael Ansah, as Derek said, he should calculate his punches very well. Accuracy.
Round.
Make sure your punches that are landing is having an effect on your opponent, and that is where you can wear your opponent down and get a knockdown.
Moving on, we just entered the fourth round now. Opportunity for the two boxers again to take an opportunity at each other. Jeez. Komlan dodges that nicely. Komlagan, that is. And he seems to have some air of confidence around him, the Togolese. And he's not swayed at all by all the antics, tactics from the shorter Michael Ansah. Works on the body now, trying to come through, and it's still that left jab that leads. And Komlagan, I'll try to open that nicely. Well, clearly that's another animated Togolese. Works nicely on the body now. That was a good shot. And very clear and obvious that the lead jab seems to open the opportunity for the big right shot. Well calculated. Misses. And then misses again. Well, a couple of misses from both boxers. Again, but definitely it's not happening. Both boxers will exchange a couple more blows. The Togolese seems to be throwing a lot of punches and keeps bubbling around. Then he goes in for the clinch.
What is Togolese doing in the style of boxing and the way his movement is has reminded me of Emmanuel Augustus. You can remember him. He was dubbed the Drunken Master because of his movement in the ring. He kind of deceived his opponents with his style of boxing and his movement. He always comes into the ring and he doesn't stand at one place. He tries to bait his opponent with his drunken master language style, and that is what Komlagan is doing. And I expect Michael Ansah to do the justice to his opponent, because Komlagan, the kind of wheel and acceleration he started from round one, that is not what we are seeing. So his punches are really down the belt and is really slowing down.
Round
and I'm expecting Michael Ansah, how experienced he is, he should be able to knock out this opponent. And that's what we are talking about. He shouldn't be throwing flurry and wild punches. Be calculated and select your punches very, very well. And if he does that, we are sure he can get the job done as the Togolese is in front of him in this round five.
Good shot to the body from Michael Ansah. Lightweights, tricky business for boxers in that division. That's a big one. Oh, that went to the head of Komlagan. Now the fans are trying to get behind him. Komlagan, the legs are unstable. He's going to rest on the ropes for support. Michael Ansah believes that this is it, and that is over.
And Prince, that is what we are talking about. He should give his punches back to nature. Accurate is the key. And you can see on your screen, and extremely happy on that occasion, on the exhibition of the Ghanaian international, Michael Ansah. And as we are talking about, right from round one to round two, and that is what we are talking about, he should be able to size it up. That is what we are looking for. Increase the tally of knockout to 17. Previously it was 16, and now it's going to go up to 17. Job well done from the Ghanaian international, Michael Ansah. And you can see that Togolese went in there. Great sportsmanship from him. Going to congratulate the Ghanaian international. Accuracy was the key. As we keep pressing on, accuracy, select your punches very well, because the Togolese was already one out. What is left is accuracy. And that's a job well done from the Ghanaian international. Kudos to Michael Ansah for winning this title.
Prince, I think good job by Michael Ansah. I think he's done what we all expected him to do. The referee did so well. We don't want any, you know, these days, little we hear, one boxer is dead in the ring, the other boxer, he was in South Africa, he came to Nigeria. So as a referee, when you see a boxer who is uncontrollably not, you know, and it's
no coordination,
right frame of mind, the best thing to do is to stop the fight. That's exactly what the referee did. The Togolese boxer was nowhere near, it was clearly off track, and the referee stopped the fight. I think that we must applaud One Bullet and Sam for a good job done. He's gotten a title before his much awaited Commonwealth bout in the UK. We wish him the best. He's done so well, and we expect him to go out there and get out the Commonwealth belt. And he's capable. He's very much capable of delivering that for Mother Ghana.
For the kind of quality that he's shown us this evening, you think it should be water of a duck's back to pick up the Commonwealth title?
No, One Bullet Ansah is one boxer who has a bit of discipline problem. In it,
so we are now ready for the verdicts. So the referee is here. We have the verdicts. The JBA president will do us the honor to do the crowning moment. So, ladies and gentlemen, shall we put our hands together for the two boxes? Now we have the verdicts. In round number 5, by a technical knockout in 1:02, the new Lion Boxing Organization RBO lightweight champion is no other person than the boxer who is also known to be called One Bullet, Michael Ansah. So Alhaji Fadi Fota and Isaac Tete, they have crowned a new champion. Let me just have a word with him. Now, Michael Tete.
Fine, sir.
Inaka Emitifio. It was turn on the thing.
And then, dear Shoma Bossa, because many of the first in the champion can be. Kajina can go by easy. Shoma Shay going in there in easy because he had a near pressure. Yes, whatever pressure, I said, a near pressure. One in there.
Very well. Be an auto world champion, Lion Boxing Organization. On our mission, what are you
doing? Because boxing, I do my own battle. We are the one. We are the one. We are the one.
Be an a mini young boy. You can have offense anybody be in their numbers.
We don't have to defend your position. Before we again fight, be an. I'm a user. I'm a poor fighter. We are not fast defense. I will not give you no one.
Now the GBA president. Now, before I go to the GBA president, I think the my very good friend, Komlagan, I understand you are not happy with the verdict. If you parle français, English now, why do you think that because the referee saw that you were receiving hand? So you want a refight?
Rematch. Now everything will be clear.
So he wants a rematch. Shall we put our hands together for him? Thank you very much. Now viewers and those of us here, three Ghanaian boxers will fight him. One has already fought and he is now going home with the bronze. We have two boxers who are going to fight for the gold medal in UK in Birmingham. All of us must pray for them. I'm talking about Komi and then Abraham, because Abdul Wahid has already actually ended. He is going home with the bronze. My name is Mohammed Amin Lamte. On behalf of the production team and everybody, we thank you so much. We are back 2 weeks to come. Stay blessed, but then be good. Bye for now.
Listen to me.
I'm the Spafford National Champion. I'm the Lightweight National Champion. I'm the PB's Lightweight National Champion.
I'm a true champion.